Tama, Doktor. Ako po ay dati, I used to be a rural health physician in a fifth class municipality when I'm back in 1991. During my time, ang unang kaso kong hinandel nung ako ay pumasok sa RHU was to sign a death certificate na hindi ko alam dahil yung patay ay ililibing na. So due for burial. So they cannot bury the dead because there's no death certificate. And they had been mourning for a week already. And ang pumunta po doon was a relative. I think it was the sister of the person who died. And they don't stay in one place, meaning they were already grown up, so they have their own families. So the sister just related to us what she knew about what happened to her brother while still alive and sick. At naloko po ako sa kakaisip if what disease took place doon sa cause of death, underlying cause of death. Diba naman sa medical school, we were not taught how to complete or to fill a death certificate. Ang isa pang verse, we were not even taught how to pronounce death. Diba? Nung nasa San Lazaro ako noon, tinawag ako, Dok, mag-pronounce po kayo ng patay. Ano sasabihin ko sa patay? Eh, patay na. Alam mo, I pronounce you dead? So these are simple and yet very traumatic experience to all of us doctors who are just starting our profession. And up to this time, if I will be going back again and look at the death certificate, because our bureau is the bureau in the Department of Health that looks and counts on the mortality rate, the leading cause of mortality, as well as the leading cause of morbidity. So most of the time, nahihirapan kami because of the cause of death, hindi namin alam kung anong pipiliin na yung mga different types of health conditions being recorded. Before I was assigned as director of the Epidemiology Bureau, I was assigned in the Bureau of Quarantine. And the worst is even worse in the Bureau of Quarantine. May mga OFWs who come in dead. And in the death certificate, nakalagay lang doon, stop breathe. Diba? So how can we come up with a good picture of illnesses that causes high mortality in the population? And I think this is one opportunity for the country because I believe na ito application will help us minimize the gray hair in our head, thinking of the cause of death. So it's important to localize, although this is a foreign concept, I would love to see this localized in the Philippine scenario. Kasi iba rin po yung scenario natin sa Pilipinas. And that is very critical in making this application successful. This is the beginning of a partnership. Because I'm looking forward that this initiative will not stop in the pilot stage. I was even asking at the back, what would be the next step for this project? I'm interested with this application because I know how it feels to be in the field and the challenge to be in the field. And that would help us with our, how we would be diagnosing our cases or those who died.